ओके स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 11th मैथमेटिक्स सीबीएसई। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रेट लाइन। ओके, जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रेट लाइन एंड वी विल कन्वर्ट दिस इन डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स, दैट इज स्लोप, इंटरसेप्ट फॉर्म एंड वी विल कन्वर्ट दिस आल्सो इन नॉर्मल फॉर्म ऑफ द इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन। ओके, after that we will find the distance of a point from the general equation of the line and lastly we will find the distance between two parallel lines that are in general form or that are not in general form. Okay, so today's focus of the study is on the general equation of the line. Now what does mean by the general equation of the line? General equation of the line of first degree in two variable is given as ax plus by plus c equals to 0. Okay, means it will contain variable x, variable y, coefficient of variable x, coefficient of variable y and constant c. Okay, so this is the general equation of the line. Now we will convert this general equation of the line in slope intercept form. So first of all we will convert this in slope intercept form. Okay, slope intercept form, we know that slope intercept form is y equals to mx plus c. This is the slope intercept form where m is the slope and c is the intercept on y axis. Okay, so we will convert this general equation of line in this slope intercept form. So by is equals to minus ax minus c. Okay, now y is equals to minus a upon b into x minus c upon b. Okay, so we have converted the given general equation of the line in the form y equals to mx plus c. Okay, now we will compare this equation and this equation. We will have slope of general equation of line is equals to m is equals to coefficient of x that is minus a upon b. A is the coefficient of x and b is the coefficient of y, means equals to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. Okay, this is the slope from general equation of the line. Now c means the intercept on y axis. So intercept on y axis that is equals to minus c upon b, constant term that is minus c upon b equals to minus constant divided by coefficient of y. Okay, so intercept on y axis equals to minus c upon b that is minus constant divided by coefficient of y. Okay, so in this way we can convert the given general equation of the line in slope intercept form, or we can find the slope and the intercept on y axis whenever general equation of the line is given, and this is slope and this is intercept. Okay, now this was the first topic. Now we will convert the given general equation of the line in intercept form. Okay, so conversion of the general equation of the line in intercept form. Students, we know that the intercept form of the equation of the line is x upon a plus y upon b is equals to 1, where a is the coefficient A is the intercept on the x-axis and B, B is the intercept on the y-axis. Okay, so intercept form of the equation of the line is, we know that intercept form of the line is x upon a plus y upon b is equals to 1. Okay, so we will convert this equation first, that is general equation of line, in this form. Okay, so ax plus by is equals to minus c. Okay, now to obtain plus 1 in right hand side, we have to divide this equation by minus c, whole of the equation divided by minus c. Okay, so divide above equation by minus c, we will have ax plus by upon minus c is equal to minus c upon minus c. Okay, so this can be written as minus a upon c into x minus plus minus b upon c into y is equal to plus 1, and this can also be written as x upon minus a upon c plus y upon x upon minus c upon a, minus c upon a minus c upon b is equal to 1. Okay, so we have converted the given general equation of line in the form of intercept form. Okay, now this one is the intercept on x-axis and this one is the intercept on y-axis. Okay, so x intercept is equal to minus c upon a, and y intercept is equal to minus c upon b. Okay, so in this way we can convert the given general equation of the line in intercept form, or we can find the x-intercept and y-intercept. X-intercept is minus c upon a. Minus c upon a, that is minus constant upon coefficient of x. Minus constant upon coefficient of x. And y-intercept is minus c upon b, that is minus constant upon coefficient of y. Okay, so using these formula we can find the intercept either on x-axis or on y-axis from the general equation of the line. Okay, student, today we are discussing the general equation of the line. General equation of the line, conversion of this general equation of the line in different forms of the line. Now we will convert this general equation of the line in normal form. Okay, so normal form of the equation of the line. Normal form of the equation of the line, we are converting normal form of the equation of the line. Student, we know that the normal form of the equation of line is the x cos omega plus y sin omega is equals to p, where omega is the angle made by the perpendicular to the line with the positive direction of x axis, and p is the distance of the given line, b is the perpendicular distance of the given line from the origin. Okay, so we will find two things, omega and p, in conversion of the given general equation of the line in normal form. Okay, so normal form of the equation of line, we know that x cos omega plus y sin omega is equal to p. This is the normal form of the equation of the line. This is the general form of the equation of the line. Now we will compare this and this. We will compare this one and this one so that we can find the value of omega and p. Okay, clear all of you?
Now, comparing this, we will have a upon cos omega equals to b upon sin omega equals to c upon minus t is equals to 0, so c upon minus b.
Okay, so after comparing first and second, a upon cos omega, b upon sin omega, c upon minus t. Okay,
so from this we can have a upon cos omega equals to c upon t, a upon cos omega equals to minus c upon t, or what we can write down, cos omega equals to minus a t upon c. Cos omega is equals to minus a t upon c. Similarly, b upon sin omega equals to minus c upon t. So sin omega is equals to minus b t upon c.
Okay, so cos omega and sin omega. Now from these two equations, we will have cos square omega plus sin square omega. This is equals to minus a t upon c whole square plus minus b t upon c whole square. So this is equals to a square plus b square p square upon c square. P square upon c square. Okay. Cos square omega plus sin square omega equals to 1. So solving this, we have to find the value of c. Okay. So c square equals to p square. P square is equals to c square upon a square plus b square, or what we can write down, p equals to plus minus c upon under root a square plus b square. This is p. Okay, so distance of the line from origin, perpendicular distance of the line from the origin, that is p is equals to plus minus c upon under root a square plus b square. Okay, now we can find the value of cos omega and sin omega also using the value of p from this. Okay, so from this, cos omega equals to minus a t upon c, so minus, that is plus minus a upon c into p, that is c upon under root a square plus b square. So c means cancel c, so cos omega equals to plus minus a upon under root a square plus b square. Okay, cos omega. Similarly, sin omega equals to plus minus b upon under root a square plus b square. Okay, so cos omega and sin omega and p. Cos omega and sin omega and p. By using these two, cos omega and sin omega, we can find the value of omega. We can find the value of omega, and this is the perpendicular distance. Okay, by this way, we can convert the given general equation of the line in normal form. Okay, so this is the conversion. Students, till now we were converting the given general equation of the line in slope intercept form, and normal equation of the line. Okay, now we will move forward to find the distance of the point. Okay students, now we will move forward to find the distance of the point from the given general equation of the line. Okay, are you understanding what I am saying? Now topic is perpendicular distance of point P, x
x1 y1 from general equation of line. General equation of line. Okay, so this is our topic of discussion. Students, first of all, the general equation of line is ax plus by plus c is equals to 0. Okay, so this is y axis, this is x axis. Okay, now ax plus by plus c is equals to 0. We intersect x axis and y axis. This equation is of the form like this. Okay, this line first will intersect x axis on x axis means y equals to 0 minus c upon a at the point minus c upon a and 0. Okay, and this line will intersect y axis that is x equals to 0 minus c upon b, 0 minus c upon b at the point 0 minus c upon b. This line will intersect x axis at this point p, and at this point q on y axis. Okay, now we have to find the distance of this line from the given point. The given point is this px1 y1, so we have to find this perpendicular distance. We want to find this perpendicular distance, that is pm. This is PQ and this is RM. We want to find the distance RM. Okay, so join this point to this and this point to this. We will have a triangle PQR. Okay, we will use the formula of area of triangle to find this distance. Okay, now in triangle PQR, P is x1 y1, P is minus c upon a and 0, q is 0 minus c upon b, and r is x1 y1. Okay, so these are the coordinate of the vertices of the triangle PQR. Okay, now in triangle PQR, area of triangle PQR R is equals to half of the base that is PQ into height that is RM. Okay, now our target is also to find the distance RM, distance of the point x1 y1 from the line, that is RM. So we want to find RM. So RM equals to 2 into area of triangle PQR divided by PQ. Okay, now 2 into area of triangle PQR upon PQ. So first we have to find the area PQR and distance PQ. Okay, so we are having two things to find, that is area PQR and PQ. Okay, so area PQR is equals to, area of triangle PQR is equals to half of x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. So half of x1 x2 x3 y1 y2 y3, x1 is minus c upon a, y2 minus y3 minus c upon b minus y2 minus y3 plus x2 is 0, y3 minus y1, y1 minus 0, plus x3 is x1 into y1 minus y2, y1 minus y2, 0 minus minus plus c upon b. Okay, so this is the area of triangle. Write down this in simplest form: minus c upon a, minus c c upon a minus c upon b plus minus 1. Okay. So solving this we can have c square upon ab plus c y1 upon a 0 plus c x1 upon b. Okay. Taking ab as common, taking ab as common 1 by 2 ab as LCM, we will have c square plus c y1 plus c x1. Again taking c, c upon 2 ab as common c x1, sorry, x1 solving this
we will have
taking ab as LCM, ab as LCM, ठीक है, okay, 1 by 2 c square plus b c y1 plus a c x1, okay,
now from this side
area of triangle we are finding PQR and this is equals to c upon 2ab, c upon 2ab, taking c as common in numerator upon 2ab we will have ax1 plus by1 plus c, okay, this is the area of the triangle, this is the area of this triangle. Now we will find PQ. PQ is the distance between the point P and Q, and PQ is equals to x2 minus x1, 0 minus minus plus c upon a whole square plus minus c upon b minus 0 whole square. So this is equals to c square upon a square plus c square upon b square, and this is equals to c upon a b under root a square plus b square. This is PQ. This is PQ. After solving this, we will have PQ is equals to c upon a b under root a square plus b square. Now we have to put these two values, area of triangle PQR and PQ, in RM. RM equals to 2 into area of triangle PQR divided by PQ. So 2 into area of triangle PQR is equals to c upon 2ab into ax1 plus by1 plus c upon PQ c upon ab under root a square plus b square. So 2 will cancel 2, ab will cancel a, c will cancel c. So RM is equals to, we will have ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square. This is the distance
that we always take positive.
So this is always positive. Okay. This is the distance of the point R x1 y1 from the line PQ. And this is equals to ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square. Okay. Now
we are having the one more topic, that is distance between two parallel lines.
Okay. So distance between two parallel lines. So the topic is distance between two parallel lines. Distance between two parallel lines. Okay.
We are having two parallel lines. Okay.
So we have to find the distance. Student, we know that ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0 is the first line, and ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0 is the second line. This is first line, this is second line, both lines are parallel.
Parallel means they are having the same coefficient of x and y. Two lines are parallel if they are having the same coefficients of x and y. Okay,
so same coefficient of x and y
but different constants. Okay, if constants are also same, then they are coincident lines. When they are not two lines, they are same lines. Okay, coincident lines.
But these are two parallel lines. So this is y-axis, this is x-axis. Let us suppose that this is first line, this is line 1, this is line 2. Okay,
now how to find the distance between these two lines? The main thing is that how to find the distance between these two lines.
Now first line will intersect the x-axis at the point actually diagram should be like this. Diagram should be like this. This is first line, this is second line. Okay,
this will also intersect y-axis. This will also intersect y-axis.
This is first line, this is second line. First line will intersect x-axis at the point minus c upon a and 0. Minus c1 upon a
minus
point is minus c1 upon a and 0, and this point is minus c2 upon a
and 0. So don't we need this.
Now this is the point on the line L1. We have to find the perpendicular distance between these two lines. Distance between parallel lines means perpendicular distance between these two lines. So we are having the point on first line. So we will find distance of this point from this line, second line. Now distance between parallel lines is equals to distance of point P. Let's suppose that this point is P from line L2. Okay, so distance is point is minus C1 upon A, first line, second line is this. So A into X1 is minus C upon A, plus B into Y1 is 0, plus C2 upon under root A square plus B square. This is the formula for finding the distance, that is AX1 plus BY1 plus C upon under root A square plus B square. Distance of the point this from the line this will be find by using that formula. Okay, we have recently proved that formula. Now solving this, A will cancel A, minus C1 plus C2 upon under root A square plus B square. So this can be write down as C2 minus C1 upon under root A square plus B square. Okay, C2 minus C1 upon under root A square plus B square. This is the distance
between two parallel lines. Okay, so in this way you can find the distance between two parallel lines whenever two lines are given. Difference between their constants divided by under root square of coefficient x plus square of coefficient y. Okay,
now we are having one more topic to discuss. We are having one more topic to discuss, that is perpendicularity and paralleling of the two lines
whenever lines are given in general form.
Suppose that two lines are given as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0, and second line is given as a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equals to 0. This is first line, this is second line. slope of first line. Slope of first line is equals to minus a1 upon b1. Slope of second line. Slope of second line. That is equals to minus a2 upon b2.
Okay. We can find the slope from the general equation of the line. That is minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y.
Okay, so minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y is the slope of first line, and similarly the slope of second line.
Now,
lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. If slope m1 equals to slope m2, slope of the first line is equal to the slope of second line. That is why minus a1 upon b1 equals to minus a2 upon b2. Okay, means a1 upon a2 equals to b1 upon b2. This is the condition
of parallelism of two lines.
Now, lines are perpendicular. Lines are perpendicular. If slope m1 into m2 is equals to minus 1, that is minus a1 upon b1 into minus a2 upon b2 is equals to minus 1. That is a1 upon a2,
a1 upon a2,
a1 a2, b1 upon b2, b2 equals to minus 1, or a1 a2 equals to minus b1 b2. Minus b1 b2, or this can be write down a1 a2 plus b1 b2 is equals to 0. So this is the condition.
This is the condition of perpendicularity of two lines whenever lines are given in general form. Okay. So students, today's focus of the study was the general equation of the line. Conversion of the general equation of the line in different forms of the line, and then distance. Then distance means distance of a point from the general equation of the line and distance between two parallel lines. Okay, and condition of perpendicularity, condition of parallelism whenever lines are given in general form. Okay, so I think this will be beneficial for all of you. Okay, thank you.